across the region. WordPress is a huge part of Vodien's customers, with over 34% of Vodien's customers running WordPress. Rui Hang has knowledge and experience with using and optimizing WordPress for blogs, websites, and today he will share with us 5 tips to optimize WordPress to be faster and more secure. Rui Hang, please.
Okay, hi everyone, I'm Rui Hang and I'm from Vodien Internet Solutions. So I'm very happy to be here at WordCamp 2016 today. So today I'm going to share with our experience as a web hosting service provider in Singapore, 5 tips to optimize WordPress to be faster and also more secure. So before I move on into my topic, I'll share just a little bit on what Vodien does. So we are manage a cloud service hosting provider in Singapore. So we manage a lot of web hosting related services to customers from different regions, segments, and also industries. So at Vodien, we pride ourselves upon our 24/7 super support. So for all your web hosting related questions and support related stuff, we'll be there for you. So the surprising thing or the interesting thing about Vodien is that 34% of our customers, they're actually using WordPress websites. So this has actually changed our the way that Vodien operates. So because of this, we even came up with a dedicated application support team. So this support team, they will work on cases, taking on cases like for content management systems. And WordPress is one big component of that. So we handle WordPress related issues, and also at times we tackle when people or customers need us to optimize their sites. So a little bit more on myself. So before joining Vodien, I had zero experience with WordPress. So I've been at Vodien for around at least 2 years. So I worked on the content marketing portion. So this has allowed me to interact with my content writers and working on the blogs, and also our knowledge bases, which is the public and for internal use as well. And also setting up like a company news portal for our team leaders, for managers to share updates on the company. So this is, I'm sure many of you, you have built websites or even company blogs, e-commerce sites. So this is how WordPress is. It's just a simple, effective, and scalable to any use. So today I'll be sharing the 5 tips in a sort of like a process flow. So starting before looking at creating your WordPress website, maybe you can look at finding a good web host to host your site. And after that, something about building on your websites and which are the plugins that you can use. And the third point is caching and optimization, followed by cleaning up your site. And lastly is what are the options that you can look at to beef up the security for your website. So I'm sure many of you already have managed a web hosting service providers already. So but take this opportunity to see whether the web hosting environment is optimized for your website. So first of all, ask yourself whether you are targeting where are the customers you are targeting. If you, let's say you are targeting customers from Singapore, you can always look at having a Singapore web host. So why is this so? The Singapore web host, they have a local servers, so it you allow your website to reach out to your clients in Singapore more effectively and faster. And also Singapore web hosts, they do have local support team. So if you are in Singapore, then the support team, they are in the same time zone as you. So be it that you are in, so during office hours, if you have questions or you have support related issues, you can just look for them and they'll be very, very responsive. And also with local servers, you will look at faster speeds for your websites. So this will in a way help you to boost the local page rankings. So help you with your SEO elements as well. So the second thing you can look at is whether they allow you to select the PHP version for your website. So for example, for WordPress, some of the plugins require at least a PHP version of 5.6. So I've encountered around two or three of them already. So because of this, I had to upgrade our site to a newer version, or our blog page to a newer version to be able to install these new plugins. So but before doing so, always check with your web hosting service provider what are the things that you should look at before upgrading the PHP version for your website. So next, look at what are the server optimization that your web host does for you. So look at the things that what they do to help you increase server efficiency. So to allocate better resources to your WordPress website so that you can target more customers. And also what are the things that they look at to minimize the downtime for your website. So to talk more about this, I'll share a case study, which is using our Vodien blog. So Vodien blog, we have did a revamp on this just this year. So previously on the left side, you see it's a very, very old team. So it was non-responsive and it was on our old website design. So this year, our developers or designers, we came out with a new design. So this is a new team. So it's responsive and it also shows our very nice category list, which looks something like this. So after building this, we realized that actually it was taking quite a while for our website to load. So for this each individual featured images to show up, it was taking around approximately around 10 seconds to load this page fully. So because we realized that each of these images, they were pulling from the different databases. So it contributed to a long loading speed for the website. So because of this, I had worked with my developers. We are looking at which are the plugins that were causing all these load time issues. So even installed different caching modules and tweaked to the settings. But all this worked on all this on application level, which on the WordPress level, and we realized that it didn't really help us with our site loading speed. So we had to consult our infrastructure team. So from there, they analyzed our site and our blog site and realized that we should actually move to a newer server because our Vodien blog was actually on one of our very old Pioneer servers, which was also on a very old PHP version 5.3. So we migrated to a new server, which was at least PHP 5.6. And this had already had some form of optimization to it. So that, there are things that, such as an op cache that's automatically installed for servers on PHP 5 and above, 5.5 and above. So this is all very technical stuff. And also our infrastructure team, they help us with the server optimization. So they installed things such as memcache, it's all this kind of server level caching. So after this, we went to test out the site, the loading speed. So it improved at least around 3 times. So we didn't do any tweaking to our plugins. So our loading speed for this page was around 3 seconds. So at times you have to look at not only optimizing on the application level, you should also look at whether your web host can optimize on the server level so that your WordPress website will perform optimally. So what makes a good web host? You also have to think of what they have done for the security for your servers. So what are the methods they employ for server hardening, whether they have anti-malware installed, and whether they have firewalls on the web application level and also on the server level. So this will protect and prevent attackers for your websites. And also, what are the support that they provide for you for WordPress-related issues? So do they help you with WordPress issues, or do they just ask you to look for your developers or designers whenever you have something wrong with your website? So the best thing is that your web host, they'll provide you with the next steps you can take, or even they can even offer you, the best is that they can offer you with maybe paid services to help you to clean up your site or even optimize your WordPress website. So moving on, the second part is on the themes and plugins portion. So there's so many themes out there, free or paid versions. So just to give a quick run through. So for free themes, the good thing about them is, of course, they're free of charge. And these are always reviewed by the WordPress community before they're served. So, and also these themes, they cover to a specific need. So if you're looking for a WordPress theme that's catered specifically to building a blog, so they only have functions for like cater to the blog area. So it's very clean and lean, so keep your WordPress site as simple. But as for paid themes options, the good point about them is that they provide you with regular updates to the designs, the customizations, and also they provide you with support to their team as well. So you can look for them through the emails, or even some of them, the bigger ones, they have forums that allow you to post questions and have people looking after the questions, answering them and consolidating them. And also, these paid themes, they have greater functionalities, so that you can look at even creating a blog or e-commerce site from using a similar theme. And lastly, they also adhere to higher security standards as well, because after all, this is a paid theme service, so whenever there's a new WordPress vulnerabilities out there, you'll be very fast at patching it up and protecting the users. So talking about all this, this is one of my personal favorite theme. It's a DV theme brought by Elegant Themes. So this theme is really very useful. It's first of all responsive, and also it can cater to many types of websites that you want to build, be it for your blogs or for your e-commerce sites. And the awesome thing about this theme is that they provide you with this premium plugin free of charge once you purchase the theme. This is called the DV Builder. So it's basically like a drag and drop website builder to allow you to create a web page, your landing pages, or even a website from scratch. So you do not even need to have a technical skills for it. So I do not have any coding skills or CSS skills, but I've actually used this to build a WordPress site from scratch. So on the left, you see this is the default page creator. And at the right-hand side, you can see this is what DB Builder looks like. So you drag and drop modules to put in your elements for your landing page or your website. And after this, talk about some caching and optimization portion. So at Vodien, we host some of the bigger news and entertainment sites in Singapore. And many of them, they are running on WordPress sites as well. So at times, they come to us to ask us to optimize our website. So the first thing that we always look at is whether they have installed caching for their website. So maybe a show of hands, how many of you have actually installed caching plugins on your site? Yeah, okay. So what is so good thing about this caching module? I'll just share a recent example. So one of these news and entertainment website, they had actually a viral post recently, and it brought a really huge, enormous surge in traffic to their website. So because of this, we looked into the issue and realized that they did not install or activate the caching plugin that was in their website. So because of this, this is like the default behavior of WordPress. It's a database powered platform. So every time a visitor reach your WordPress post, all the elements have to be loaded. So like the plugins, the content from the database, the images and the JavaScripts, all has to be loaded for this one visitor. So imagine if you have a thousand of visitors loading your page at one single time. So this will really cause a huge load on your website. So what caching will help you to do is that it help you to reduce this load by creating this temporary place to store all your website data. So all the plugins, all the content, images, they'll all be stored as a static HTML before they are served to your customers or your visitors. So essentially, you're like serving a cache copy or static HTML file to your customers. So this will help with your website performance, be it for your loading speeds or whenever you're catering to a high volume of visitors. So with this, which WordPress caching plugin that you can use? So for the rest of you who haven't installed a caching module, these are the two simple plugins that you can use. So for myself, a non-technical user, I'll always use the WP Super Cache. So this is really very easy caching plugin to use. So you just have to install it and remember to activate it. So minimal settings are required. So there are these recommended settings portion. So you just have to follow through them and you could see some good results for your website already. And as for W3 Total Cache, the one on the right, it's actually what our engineers always recommend to the web developers out there. So what it does better is that it also provides database level caching. So this will also work very well with server-side optimization, like the one I mentioned previously, which is like for opcache or memcache portions. And a better way to categorize these two plugins is if you want to handle higher traffic to your site, you can look at installing WP Supercache. And if you want to serve more content to your visitors out there, you can look at having W3 Total Cache. So regardless of which of the plugins you use, always remember to turn on caching after installing a plugin. And also take the chance to test or experiment with either plugins or settings to see which one gives a better boost to your website. So next, if you have many images or high-resolution images on your website, you can also look at having such a plugin called WP Smash. So this is a plugin that helps you to optimize the images without losing any quality. So essentially what it does is it reduces the file size of your images. So you're serving the same type of image to your customers, but they are taking lesser resources to load. So WP Smash. And next, you can also look at having a plugin to manage all your other plugins as well. So this plugin is called P3 Performance Profiler. So what it does is tells you your plugin's effect on your website. So allows you to know which are the plugins that are causing the load time for your site, and also allows you to know which are the plugins that are poorly configured. And with this information, you can look at which are the plugins you should replace or remove, or which are the plugins that you can further optimize. So the cool thing about this is they also have this a report on the plugin's performance. So with one view, like for example, on the you see as a pie chart over there, it'll tell you which are the plugins that are actually contributing to the loading speed of your website. And also for database optimization portion, you can look at having a plugin called WPDB Manager. This WordPress plugins help you to optimize or repair your database. And the cool thing about it is also it can help you to schedule your database backup. So this is very important when you're upgrading your WordPress version or doing any content upgrade to your website. So for the above actions or like optimization, repairing portions, you can always schedule the actions. For example, you can do a bi-weekly optimization of your database. So this can be easily achieved through this DB Manager plugin. So the fourth portion is about cleaning up your website. So after you have created your website, I'm sure you have already installed many plugins out there. So these plugins, you must remember to always deactivate them and delete them after using them, or after you're not using them anymore. So you can always use a plugin known as WP Sweep to clean up the plugin after deactivating them. So why is it so important to delete all these unused plugins? It's because these plugins, you may forget to update them, and it could serve as a point of entries for injections or hacks out there. And also, you can look at activating hot link protection. So this is, like for example, all your hosted images, they're actually public. So anyone with the URL, they can actually use your image, host on their own website while using your own bandwidth. So this is a very important thing to prevent bandwidth theft. So this will prevent other websites from linking to or embedding your files on their own website. And what's worse, they're using your bandwidth to do so. So there are two methods that you can prevent hot linking. First of all is through your web hosting control panel. So most of you will be familiar with cPanel. You can enable this option known as hot link protection. And the second option is you can do it through HDSS. But this is only recommended for developers out there, because of one single code that you put in wrongly, it may even bring down your whole site. So always remember to whitelist your other subdomains or domains that may be related to your main website after doing so. And the last portion, I'll talk a bit on security. So the very important thing is to install security plugins for your website. So there are three plugins that we always like to use. It's a Ninja Firewall, all-in-one WP Security and Firewall. And lastly, Security Security. So it's quite a tongue twister. So the ones that I like to use is called the Ninja Firewall. So regardless of which one you use, they all work as a web application firewall. So other functions are such as anti-malware, real-time file system security, blacklist functionality as well. And also they protect you from the latest WP vulnerabilities out there. So for non-technical people like myself, when I always hear of stuff such as SQL injections, cross-site scripting, and also brute force attacks, these are the stuff that really intimidate us non-technical people out there, because we don't really know how to fix our website once our website is affected by all these common threats. So always remember, prevention is better than cure. So install all those security plugins to protect your site today. So lastly, some miscellaneous tips to help you secure your WordPress website. So I believe this is always repeated and recommended by other people. Do not use the username admin or other easy to guess usernames such as maybe your company name. So this will help you to lower the risk of brute force attacks out there. And also to better prevent against brute force attacks, you can create a custom WordPress login URL. So I believe the basic login URL out there is like wp-admin, wp-login. So these are people, we all know these are the common login URL. So you can create a custom one so that it's something that only you or your developers know, so there's a more secure platform for you to log into. And always, lastly, always remember to update your WordPress website and your plugins to the latest version as soon as possible. But before doing so, before upgrading like your WordPress versions or your plugins version, be sure to check are they like 100% compatible? Because if not, like for example, if you're upgrading your WordPress site, you're upgrading the WordPress version, you should look at which plugins are not compatible, and maybe you can deactivate them before updating the site. Yeah, so after updating the site to the latest version, you can then activate the plugin again to see whether it's really compatible with your website. Yeah, so with this, I bring it to the end of the speech. So if you have any questions, yeah.
Page or a form submission page which I use like for meetable form for people to for example procedure or something like that, or do a registration. Is there a way I can enable this without install a captcha, because I really don't want people have to type a captcha in order to register.
So this is like a form that you use to for you your users to register for your website.
Formidable
for forms. So I believe I'm not sure if how formidable forms works, but I believe you can disable the option for captcha, right? For
yeah, because I don't want the user to do a captcha in order to register.
You know,
I also don't want the spam or anything.
Ah, okay. So to register to spam, or maybe the
to register without captcha and without spam.
Oh, this is really a challenging portion. Because for me, for our forms out there, we always use the Google Recaptcha to... So they just have to click it or just to select some images before they can continue on. But I think this is always good to have captcha for your website for registration portions.
If you want user to do a captcha in order to register, I think that's too much. I want them just to put email, password and register.
I believe there are other maybe contact forms out there that instead of them registering on your site, you just capture the information, their information, so it is stored in your WordPress site instead of going through the registration form. Yeah.
Okay. So. I think if there's any other questions, we can take it offline from here. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. Okay,
so
thank you all.
Guys, because thank you very much. Okay, so now we'll proceed.